Michelle and I work for California State Parks in Oceano, and it's springtime in our park right now, which means wildflowers. We have so many different kinds and I love them all. We're gonna check out one of my favorites and it's over that way. This is the giant Coreopsis, and not only is it a plant that blooms as winter turns to spring, it's also native to our area. So it doesn't grow in many places, but we get to see it in Oceano right here in our state park.
Native means that it's from here, just like we're from a certain area. Its native distribution in California is from San Luis Obispo to Los Angeles and the Channel Islands. Within this range, you'll find giant Coreopsis growing on rocky cliffs or sand dunes. The giant Coreopsis is in the sunflower family and is a perennial, meaning it lives more than 1 year. It goes dormant in the winter, but as you can see here, it comes back to life after the winter months. We love the giant Coreopsis here at Oceano Dunes because it's a little different than other native flowering plant species. Here in our state park, we have many other wildflower species, such as California poppies, carnival poppies, Indian paintbrush, Pismo clarkia, owl's clover, and so many more. What stands out as so different when comparing the giant Coreopsis to these other wildflowers is its height.
They can grow up to 6 feet in height. That's more like a tree than a seasonal blossoming plant. And its trunk can be 4 inches in diameter. Let's take a closer look at its other features.
As we get closer, you can see its leaves are fine and sort of look like the leaves of a fern. Its flowers are daisy-like and bright yellow in color. They can be up to 3 inches in diameter. That's just over the size of a baseball. Sometimes the giant Coreopsis we find here looks a little silly and scraggly, but when it's in bloom between March and May, its smiley flowers and fresh green leaves give this plant life. Because of its unique appearance, some think it looks like a tree Dr. Seuss would draw. Look at the resemblance to the trees in Dr. Seuss's The Lorax. Do you think they look similar?
Thank you so much for learning with me today. I'm going to leave you guys with a question. Can you name another flowering plant species that blossom only in the springtime? Maybe in your backyard, your neighborhood, or a nearby park? Send your responses back to me in a video. See you next time.